of Hadon. I think you are a member of the executive committee of the Solar Heating and Cooling Program, an international research program, and you are the adjuvant representative for Switzerland in this program. So what is your job about?
Yes, I am in this program. We're trying to set up an international collaboration among researchers and industries in the solar community, so to say. And this job is, the committee started like more than 40 years ago. So there's a lot of things that happen along these 40 years from the very start of the solar thermal industry to some extent to a maturity where we are now in Europe, at least, and in some part of the world as well.
So you are heading yourself an engineering company. So how can directly industry profit from the research which is done in the solar heating and cooling program?
Right. There are many ways, indeed. The first and most interesting way is to participate in what they call tasks. A task is a project, basically, when you are an engineer or an industry in this topic. So participating in a project, being around the table with others, like 5 to 10 different countries. Normally it brings 20 to 50 experts in a domain like solar lightning, like solar collectors, like thermal storage, and you can profit a lot from the experience and the knowledge of the others. Second, you can use the website of the solar heating and cooling where you will find lots of information. I think it's the focal point of solar thermal energy information in the world, I would say in English. There's many reports and articles and also some simulation tools that any user, any industry or engineer in the field can find. And you can read our books because we wrote some books. Of course, it's old-fashioned to say this, but there are lots of information what presented in a nice way. You know, an article or a report is not that kind of dense information you can find in books. So go to the website, Solar Heating and Cooling, if you try to find it, and then you'll have all the information classified by topics.
So can you name some highlights which were striking to you? Because I think you're a very long already member of this committee.
Oh, yes. We started, I must say, with seasonal storage long time ago, injecting hot water from the sun into the aquifers or into the ground. And it somehow vanished a little bit along the years because it needed very big, very large projects. And at those times, in the 70s, 80s, solar thermal projects were not that big. So we turned a little bit on smaller scale to villas, domestic housing, and also to industries to produce hot water from the sun. And along the path, we also worked on what we call solar combi systems. It was very known how to produce domestic hot water from the sun, but the IEA Solar Heating and Cooling Program has enhanced the way to do it in terms of primarily efficiency. At the end of the 80s, the work of the SHC program was very nice for what we call dream systems. We tried to have low flow DHW solar systems that actually are operating now very well after 25 years of operation or activity. Then we moved to solar combi systems, so we try to do both domestic hot water and heating. It's at least in Europe, it's like 25% of the market share is for combi systems. We also work in combination with heat pumps, for example, because you might know that hybrid systems are in favor or the favorite of the market, because it's very difficult, unfortunately, to store the solar heat we have in summertime in another hemisphere to the wintertime when we need it. We don't have what we call the seasonal storage as compact as we would like to have to be in a house. There is a program working on this, but it's long-term goal because it's basically chemistry and a mixture between chemistry, engineering, and solar industry work. And I must say the means we have in this business is too little to get to the what we call the critical mass to make real breakthrough in one decade, so to say. So it will last to get the solar storage as nice as we would like to have, it would take like more than one decade more probably ahead of us.
More to today's work. Do you have contact with solar energy in your all-day life when you do your project developing?
We have, but I must say I come from a little country, Switzerland. We are quite active in domestic hot water system because in some cantons, some part of the country, it's mandatory to have solar water, domestic hot water system. So there's not much engineering. You just say the house or the building should have that amount of square meters, but it's more a business of installers, which is nice because it pushes to the installation the industry, and it anchors it into something which is solid, I would say, because we have lots of different professionals working into it. And for big systems where more engineering companies would be needed, then for Switzerland it's a bit difficult because we're not doing that big things. You can see big interesting engineering systems in Austria, which is not a big country, by the way. It's about the same size of Switzerland, but they are much more towards big systems hooked to district heating, something we don't have in Switzerland. A few district heating, but they're running at too high a temperature, which is also a problem for solar. When you operate a system at more than 120, 30 degrees Celsius, then solar needs special collectors and sun. And this is something difficult to go. So there's also a bunch of projects dealing with low temperature district heating solution in the solar heating and cooling, where you can then inject solar heat at 60 to 70 degrees Celsius. And it is probably one of the way to go in the future. When you have a new area, you heat up with a low district heating system, and you can put solar collectors in a field on the buildings everywhere. The link is the network, and it's more easy. It's easier to inject solar into such systems than to retrofit on buildings with high temperature radiators, for example.
Thank you very much. I think there's still a lot of engineering to be done, and I think your program will have a lot of very interesting tasks in the future.